We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, the first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight. But more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud." I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight, because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee, but he belongs but he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and Western music. But I think it's really American music, because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, Northeast, West, and South. And incidentally, among the group of great stars who will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up on the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash. We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, The first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight. But more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud." And I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight, because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee, but he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and Western music, but I think it's really American music, because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America, in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, Northeast, West, and South. And incidentally, among the group of great stars who will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up in the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash. We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, the first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight. But more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud." I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight. Because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee, but he belongs but he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and Western music, but I think it's really American music because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America, in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, Northeast, West, and South. And incidentally, among the group of great stars who will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up in the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash. We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, the first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight, but more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud." I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight, because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee, but he belongs but he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and Western music, but I think it's really American music because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, Northeast, West, and South. And incidentally, among the group of great stars who will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up in the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash. We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, the first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight, but more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud." I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight, because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee, but he belongs but he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and Western music. But I think it's really American music because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, Northeast, West, and South. And incidentally, among the group of great stars who will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up in the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash. We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, the first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight, but more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud." I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight, because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. But I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee, but he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and Western music. But I think it's really American music because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, Northeast, West, and South. And incidentally, among the group of great stars who will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up in the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash. We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, the first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight. But more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud." I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight, because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee, but he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and western music. But I think it's really American music, because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, Northeast, West, and South. And incidentally, among the group of great stars who will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up on the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash. We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, the first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight. But more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud." I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight, because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee, but he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and Western music. But I think it's really American music, because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, Northeast, West, and South. And incidentally, among the group of great stars who will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up on the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash. We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, the first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight. But more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud. I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight, because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee, but he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and western music, but I think it's really American music, because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, northeast, west, and south. And incidentally, among the group of great stars who will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up in the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash. We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, the first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight. But more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud." I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight, because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee. But he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and Western music. But I think it's really American music because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, Northeast, West, and South. And incidentally, among the group of great stars who will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up in the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash. We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, the first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight, but more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud." I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight, because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. But I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee, but he belongs but he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and Western music, but I think it's really American music because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, Northeast, West, and South. And incidentally, among the group, the great stars will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up in the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash. We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, the first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight, but more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud." I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight, because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee, but he belongs but he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and Western music. But I think it's really American music because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, Northeast, West, and South. And incidentally, among the group, the great stars will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up in the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash. We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, the first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight, but more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud." I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight, because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. But I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee, but he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and western music. But I think it's really American music, because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, Northeast, West, and South. And incidentally, among the group of great stars who will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up in the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash. We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, the first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight. But more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud." I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight, because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee, but he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and western music. But I think it's really American music, because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, northeast, west, and south. And incidentally, among the group of great stars who will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up in the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash. We're very happy to welcome all of you tonight at this evening at the White House. And before I introduce our distinguished guest star and the group of stars who are with him, I think it's only appropriate for me to say that I feel this has been an historic day, one of the great days of America's history. When I talked to Captain Lovell earlier today on the phone, The first words that he spoke were to this effect. He said, "Mr. President, we're only sorry that we were unable to complete our mission as directed." And I said to him, "Captain, you and your colleagues did not reach the moon, but you did complete your mission. You returned to Earth. You came back, of course, with scientific information that we learn when mishaps occur on a space flight. But more than that, through the courage and the poise that they demonstrated and their colleagues on the ground demonstrated, the character, the ingenuity, that when machines go wrong, that in America we have people that can come up to the mark. This made us all feel very proud." And I think it's only appropriate, although we didn't plan it this way, that Johnny Cash be here tonight, because he fits. We have had many great performers in this room. In our nights at 8:30, we've had Red Skelton, the greatest clown, certainly, in American contemporary and the contemporary American scene. We've had the smash Broadway hit 1776. We've had Nicole Williamson, the greatest Shakespearean actor, perhaps, of our time. And tonight, we have Johnny Cash. It's rather hard to describe him in terms that are perhaps adequate, except for those who know his music. I'm not an expert on his music. Incidentally, I found that out when I began to tell him what to sing. I understand, incidentally, he owns a Cadillac, but he won't sing about Cadillacs tonight. I do know that he was born in Arkansas, and he now lives in Tennessee, but he belongs to the whole country. The music that he represents tonight is called country music and Western music, but I think it's really American music because it speaks to all Americans. It speaks in stories about America, in a way that touches the hearts of all Americans, Northeast, West, and South. And incidentally, among the group of great stars who will be with him will be his wife, June Carter Cash, a star in her own right. And up on the third floor is their one-month-old baby boy. We thought we should put him in the Lincoln bed. But he's a little small for that, but the way Johnny Cash is going, he'll probably end up there one day. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash.